Hey, what up, y'all? It's Knowledge the Raven 2468 coming at y'all. The question I have, and also a statement, is why do y'all think we are in this house? Did y'all know that this time was spoken in the Bible, and it was actually spoken on the date when it happened? In Isaiah chapter 26, verse 20. But when you read 12 through 21, you'll get a better understanding of what's going on. And you remember this pandemic, this whole ordeal happened on the 26th. Well, when it was announced to the world, it was announced to us on the 26th of, was it March? If I'm not mistaken, I think it was March. I could be wrong. But either way I go, I'm admitting that I'm wrong or I'm right. But anyways, it talks about this time. It talks about where God will put us inside the house and we will lock our doors. And he is going to sweep through this land and destroy those rulers that's in darkness and that have done some wrong things to his people, and even those that are still doing wrong to this day, like praising false gods, idol worship, not obeying the laws of the land that he designed for this land, and it goes into great detail in Isaiah 26, 12 through 21. And I actually put up a devotional today to give those that don't like to read the King James Version or the Message or whatever it is. I give the one that the Lord drops into my spirit. And it's called God's Protection. So if you follow me on Instagram, YouTube, or I'm sorry, Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat, then you'll be able to see it. If not, you'll be watching this here on YouTube and you'll hear about it. But either way it go, you'll get a sight of it, and then you can actually hear the word on my channel. So that's the reason I'm actually playing this song about escape, run into the arms of the one who loves you. The arms of our Father. We just need to run to him. We just need to allow him to fix us, because he loves us more than anybody else can ever love us. And like she said, you'll never have to worry. You'll never have to worry about the Father that'll keep you warm and that will give you everything that you need, that will make sure that you have all the supply that you need. That's why we're in the house, y'all. Again, because we basically were not taking care of our kids. We were letting somebody else take care of our kids. And we wasn't giving our kids the right teachings. We wasn't teaching them the laws of the land. We were doing what we wanted to do. So we're all in the house. This is just showing that everybody is equal to one another. The person that has more than you, the haves and have-nots, person that has more than you material-wise is just the same as you. He's no better than you. She's no better than you. Look at all the superstars. Everybody's sitting down. Look at all the people. Everybody's sitting down. Everybody's, well, I don't want to say scared, but some people are frightened. Some people don't understand, like, death is coming, and you better get right with God. You better get into his word and obey his teachings and stop teaching these lies to those false prophets, false preachers, whatever it is out there, to those that are not preaching the real gospel. You better get right with God, and you better get right with your family. Love on them, because you don't know when's the next time you will see them. You don't know that time. But let go of the minuscule things, the small things. Like, nothing should stop you from seeing your mother or your father, your brother, your sister, your cousin, your aunts, your uncles, your friends. Nothing should stop you from that. If something is stopping you from that, you need to check yourself. You need to check up from the neck up. Because you're not teaching, we're not teaching the right way. And And that's for all of us, you know. We have to definitely dive into our kids and teach them, spend more time with them. And I'm talking about even myself, you know, because I've even done it too, where I'm so involved in the ministry that I'll be so tired, so exhausted that I didn't even have time to spend with my children. And then they running around here like a chicken with his head cut off and just doing whatever they want to. And that's for all of us. We need to really fix up our household, clean it up, and fix our children. Raise them up the way that you want them to be. And with the way that you want them to be, you should also follow into that yourself. Because if you're going to be a leader, a great leader, a real one, you must even obey the own words that come out of your mouth. If you can't obey the words that are coming out of your mouth, how can you expect your children to obey you? How can you expect that? How can you expect that your spouse to listen to you if your words are not aligning up with your actions? So, again, go and read it for yourself, man. Go read Isaiah chapter 26, verse 12 through 21. And it's in there. And if you want to get a better understanding of it, I mean, I'm not saying that I'm better at anything, but I have the devotional posted on my Facebook channel and also my Instagram and Twitter, which is Knowledge of Raven 2468. Hey, man, I love y'all. Blessings to y'all. Knowledge.